After we take two muscles on the back of the trunk, which are trapezius and latissimus dorsi, there are two muscles in this group, which are the muscles which are connecting the upper limb to the axial skeleton on the anterior aspect of the trunk. Both muscles are called pectoralis, but there is a large pectoralis called pectoralis major and a small pectoralis called pectoralis minor. First of all, pectoralis major. Pectoralis major has two heads. Clavicular head arises from where? From the medial two-thirds of the clavicle. From the anterior border or posterior border? Sure, this is anterior view to the skeleton. Therefore, the clavicular head arises from the anterior border of the medial two-thirds of the clavicle. And there is a head called sternocostal head. I draw the muscle on the right side and I draw the origin on the left side. This muscle arises from the front of the sternum. Therefore, it's called sternum. And also arises from the upper six costal cartilage. Therefore, it is called costo. Therefore, it is called the sternocostal head. Arises from the front of the sternum and the front of the upper six costal cartilage. And the lower fibers arise from the aponeurosis of this muscle. Muscle in the abdomen called external abdominal oblique. Aponeurosis of external abdominal oblique. What is meant by aponeurosis? Aponeurosis is broad flat tendon. This muscle has here a broad flat tendon. Therefore, it is called external abdominal oblique aponeurosis, from which arises the lower fibers of sternocostal head of pectoralis major. Therefore, the origin is clavicular head from the anterior border of the medial two-thirds of the clavicle. And the sternocostal head from the front of the sternum and the upper six costal cartilage and aponeurosis of external abdominal oblique. The fibers passes laterally to be inserted in this famous groove. What is this famous groove? In the front of the shaft of the humerus. Pectoralis major inserted in the lateral lip of bicipital groove. Therefore, this is the pectoralis major, which has a clavicular head from the anterior border of the medial two-thirds of the clavicle, and the sternocostal head from the front of the sternum and the upper six costal cartilage, and the lower fibers of sternocostal head arise from broad flat white tendon, which is the aponeurosis of external abdominal oblique. The fibers passes laterally to be inserted in the lateral limb of bicipital groove. What is the nerve supply of pectoralis major? Pectoralis, sure, supplied by pectoral nerves. Two pectoral nerves, medial and lateral pectoral nerve, because it is a large muscle supplied by two nerves, medial and lateral pectoral. Never forget the nerve supply of pectoralis major and pectoralis minor. Pectoralis and the nerve supply pectoral nerves. Since the pectoralis major is a large muscle supplied by the two pectoral nerves, medial and lateral pectoral nerve. But pectoralis minor is a small minor muscle supplied only by the medial pectoral nerve. The pectoralis minor is deep to pectoralis major. Therefore, we cut here on the right side pectoralis major to see the underlying deep pectoralis minor muscle. Pectoralis minor muscle arises from the outer surface because the ribs has outer surface, anterior surface, and inside the thorax there is deep posterior surface. This muscle pectoralis minor arises from the outer surface of third, fourth, and the fifth rib. This muscle is triangular and inserted in this process. This process in the scapula, which is called coracoid process. What is the action of pectoralis minor? It pulls the coracoid process toward the origin. Pulls the coracoid process toward the origin, it pulls the scapula with the coracoid process forward and downward. What is the action of pectoralis major? The clavicular head pull the bicipital groove towards the clavicular head, towards the clavicle. This muscle passing on the shoulder joint. This muscle passing on the shoulder joint and acting on the shoulder joint. And we know that there are three axes in the shoulder joint: flexion, extension, abduction, adduction, internal rotation, and external rotation. First axis. If you pull the bicipital groove in the front of the humerus to the clavicle, which is the origin, pull the insertion in the bicipital groove towards the clavicle upward, it will produce flexion of the shoulder. Pull the bicipital groove towards the sternum by the sternocostal head. It will pull the bicipital groove and the humerus towards the sternum, which is adduction or abduction? Adduction and internal rotation. Therefore, pectoralis major produce this movement: flexion, adduction, and internal rotation, which is half of the freestyle in swimming. In swimming, the first half, which is this by pectoralis major, and the second posterior half by latissimus dorsi. We said that pectoralis major is a large muscle supplied by two pectoral nerves, medial and lateral pectoral, while pectoralis minor, which is a small muscle supplied only by medial pectoral nerve. Remember, pectoralis minor is important muscle in arteries. There is artery pass behind this muscle called the axillary artery. And the passage of axillary artery behind the pectoralis minor will divide the axillary artery to part above the pectoralis minor, part deep behind this appear to pectoralis minor, and the part below the pectoralis minor. Therefore, passage of axillary artery behind pectoralis minor will divide the artery into three parts. And behind pectoralis minor, there are axillary lymph nodes. And the axillary lymph nodes, in contrast, will be divided by pectoralis minor into level 1 axillary lymph node below the muscle, level 2 behind the muscle, and level 3 above the muscle. This is the two pectoral muscles which lies on front of the trunk, pectoralis major and pectoralis minor. Thank you for good listening.